The three rounds between two of the big names in Australian boxing today. To tell you about them, Rob Gaylor.
Thank you very much, Johnny. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Centre Ring. Marty Rowan's Good Sports International. This time, in conjunction with LucasAid, are proud to bring to you an exhibition bout. Three-minute rounds of boxing. Would you please make welcome Tony Mad Dog Miller. To spar with Tony over these three-minute rounds. I think we're going to see some fistic fury very, very shortly. Would you please welcome another one of our Australian champions, Lester Ellis.
Well, nobody knows the form or the ability or the tricks of the trade of Lester Ellis better than my co-commentator Barry Michael, because on one very significant occasion in 1985, they fought it out for the title right here at Festival Hall in Melbourne.
Yeah, John, it was a very memorable night. It was a very tough 15-round fight. I still thank Lester for giving me the opportunity. A lot of people... Over the last couple of years when I defended the title three times, thought that I wouldn't give Lester a rematch, but that was not the case. I always was willing to give him a rematch, and it just never eventuated, unfortunately. But Lester Ellis is a hell of a fighter, and I wish him all the best in the future. I'd love to see him get another opportunity to
fight. Ladies and gentlemen, your referee for this.
You were spotting him some 10 years in age.
I was, mate, yeah. I certainly was.
Which added to your performance. That was a great effort. Tony Miller, of course, the former Australian featherweight title holder. Jeff Fenwick relieved him of that title in Melbourne last year. But Tony still holds the Australian junior lightweight title. Some people in the boxing world believe that he hasn't been quite the same fighter since that hammering at the hands of Fenwick.
Well, it's really hard to say, John. He's been in with a couple of world-class opponents since. He drew with the number 9 in the world on one of the Fenwick bills. He's sparred a great deal with Fenwick since. He actually fought Lester before he fought Jeff Fenwick and put up a very, very good exhibition. He's a hell of a fighter, Tony. He's world class, definitely. I just hope to see him go on. But he's at the stage where it's difficult for him. He's up there in world class, and it's yet to be seen whether he's going to go forwards or backwards.
This is a three-round exhibition between Lester Ellis and Tony Miller, two of the greats in the boxing ranks in this country at the moment. Actually, it started off on a rather quiet note. There were some feelings that this could develop into a three-round war.
Well, you know, I think that it's going to heat up quite a bit. They fought before, and it was a close victory to Lester Ellis. A lot of people actually thought that Tony got the points on the night. I actually didn't see the fight. I was overseas. But, that hurt Tony Miller. That left hook to the body. That definitely hurt Tony Miller. Poor Lester Ellis punching very hard. He means business. Oh, a nice left hook by Tony Miller. These guys mean business now, John.
Yep. Didn't take it long to warm up at all.
And you've got to give little Tony credit. He'd be standing Lester up probably, well, a stone at least at the moment, I would think. Close to a stone, anyway, which is quite a bit in this weight category.
Lester's tall and rangy. He's quite deceptive, really, isn't he?
He is, mate. He's got lightning hand speed and heaps of power. He's got a vicious left hook to the body, and he's got a vicious right hand. His right hand is probably his most powerful punch, but the left hook to the body is a devastating weapon.
Did he have you in any serious trouble during the 15 rounds of your title fight?
He busted something in my stomach in the very first punch he threw at the start of the 15 rounds, the first round. I actually passed blood after the fight. He tore something low down.
Yeah.
After that, he didn't hurt me with any body shots, but in the third round, he hit me with a left hook, like a left uppercut, followed by a vicious right hand, and that put me in a bit of trouble. I had pins and needles in the feet for a few seconds, and I definitely knew I'd been hit.
Well,
and so did Tony Miller just then. Oh, beautiful right hand by Tony Miller. Nice counter punch.
Now, your fight with Ellis was almost 3 years ago. How much has he improved since then?
Well, you know, really, I haven't seen a great deal of Lester since then, but he's gotten a lot bigger. He's grown, putting some very good stuff together. You know,
lightning speed, hasn't he?
Lightning speed. I mean, that's a fair nickname first round.
Well, so far so good. This is going to be a bigger draw card than the international junior middleweight fight, which was over in two rounds, as we take this break. You're watching an exhibition match between Tony Miller and Lester Ellis, which went at a furious pace in the first round. With me is Barry Michael, who fought Lester Ellis for the IBF super featherweight title here in Melbourne almost 3 years ago. Tony Miller, the shorter of the two, by a goodly proportion.
He is, John. He's a good body puncher, Tony. He works well in close. He actually nailed Lester with some good right hands in the first round, but both fighters very impressive. Lester showing beautiful combinations, very powerful punching to the head and body. It's a top-class exhibition, that's for sure. You're seeing some quality stuff here.
It's hard to believe that Ellis is only 23 years of age. He seems to have been around forever.
Well, he has been around a long time. Johnny was world champion at 19 or 20. And he's on the way back now. As I said, I thought he could, after I won the world title from him, I thought that he could go on to win another world title in a heavier division, which he's up in those heavier divisions now.
Tony Miller clipped him with a glorious left hook a moment or two back, which steadied Lester for a stride.
Yeah, he's... nice puncher by Tony.
Snappy little puncher.
He is a snappy little puncher, Tony Miller. He's looking good tonight.
Tiny reach, hasn't he?
He has, but it's amazing how quick he gets up there, John, and seems to land even the, left jab against a tall opponent. Nice little uppercut by Tony. Left a loading him up in there.
Too hard.
Tony Miller in the green and gold shorts in an exhibition match against Lester Ellis, who currently holds the Australian light and light welterweight titles. Tony holds the Australian junior lightweight title. Two of the best in the business in there exchanging savage blows.
They sure are. They're both quality tradesmen.
Tony Miller was gallant in defeat when he lost his Australian featherweight title to Jeff Fenwick in Melbourne last year. Jeff never at any stage was able to put him down.
He went down in the first round, John,
did he?
If I recall, but he was sort of a little bit off balance, but after that Jeff couldn't put him down, but hit him with a million shots. But Tony surprisingly came in at 8 stone 10, which I couldn't believe, and Jeff weighed 9 stone. I think it was either he was sick or it was a big mistake with the scales or what, but he gave Jeff 4 pounds, which again at this weight is in top class is quite a great deal.
Well, the crowd certainly getting their money's worth with this is one hell of an exhibition
match
between two great exponents of the boxing art, and they are truly classical boxers, the pair of them, with plenty of zing and sting in their punches. Look at Lester, ducking, weaving, bobbing, an elusive target.
Always had beautiful natural evasion, John, and spins an opponent beautifully. He just did. Then Tony spins him back.
Did you find him a frustrating opponent?
Frustrating to hit him cleanly in the head. He moves his head very well.
You made 4 defences, of course, of that title, and the most recent August last year when you lost it to Rocky Lockridge in Great Britain, and that's when you decided to call it quits. Okay, let's take an important break and back for the third and final round of this exhibition, and it'll be a ripper.
Sure will.
Okay, back live at the Melbourne second Sports down, and Entertainment third, Centre. Final seconds round. Down now for the third and final round of this exciting exhibition contest between Lester Ellis and Tony Miller. And as Barry Michael pointed out, they'll turn on the action in this one.
Yeah, they sure will, John. I believe they've both got a great deal of respect for each other. They would have sparred hundreds of rounds over the years, and they also fought that that tough 10-round fight at the Melbourne Festival Hall.
Lester at the moment, right at the peak of his form. He's won his last seven straight by knockout.
Yeah, well, it's, you know, it's about time that he made a move now, John. I'd like to see him get an opportunity this year to fight for the lightweight or the light welterweight title of the world, because, you know, he's still got it in him.
Two beautiful left jabs from Tony Miller then as he came away from that blue corner. Gee, it's been an entertaining exhibition.
Sure has. A lot of class shown by both boys. Nice left hook by Tony.
Yeah, put Lester off balance too.
Yeah, did. Beautiful left hook underneath by Lester. Tough boy, Tony. Look at that. Tony stays in there, works away to the body. Both hands to the body from Tony Miller.
Boxing has plenty of knockers, Barry. Many people, of course, the majority, in fact, can see no redeeming feature. But I sometimes wonder if even the most hardened anti-boxing people in our community can't see the artistry and skill that, that men of this calibre.
That's exactly right, John. A lot of people really don't know what they're talking about when they knock boxing. I mean, sure, you know, fighters can sometimes get damaged, but I've been in boxing for 15 or 16 years, and I've seen but a handful. I've seen far more injuries in football and other sports, and deaths in other sports. I've met some great guys amongst the fighters I've fought, and I believe sportsmanship is stronger in boxing than any sport amongst the fighters. Respect and mutual admiration.
Wonderful mateship. You've only got to attend one of the veteran boxers' reunion dinners to realise the tremendous esteem in which they hold one another.
That's for sure. Well,
but nowadays too, the rules are so stringent. The medical guidelines are so paramount.
Yeah, that's very true, John. It's a lot safer now than it used to be in the old days. Fighters don't hang around and end up punch drunk anymore, except in very extreme cases. And in states or countries where there's no jurisdiction. But in this country, very good exhibition. Very good exhibition.
Worth a trip to Melbourne to see that.
Oh, yeah, that was really classy stuff.
A three-round exhibition between Tony Miller and Lester Ellis. And little Tony sporting a huge grin as he walked back to the red corner. I wouldn't be grinning after being in there with Lester Ellis for three rounds.
No, he's a top... top little fighter, Tony Miller. Australian champion Lester,
in just a short moment. I was talking to Troy Waters earlier today about his projected views as to how long he's going to stay in the game. And he was telling me that he's set 25 years of age as his absolute ceiling, his absolute limit. Okay, here's Rob Gaylard with Tony Miller.
Oh, it was a good workout. I did expect a pretty vigorous sort of workout from Lester. You know, he's not known as one to sort of mess around in the ring, but I certainly hope it will serve me a good stead for my junior lightweight title defence in 3 weeks' time in Sydney, Parramatta actually, for the junior lightweight title.
I'm sure all fight fans right around Australia will be wanting with bated breath to wish you the very, very best on that night. You've now got the old master over here in your corner. What's training been like?
Training with Jack. Training with Jack, I first came over here from Western Australia nearly 4 years ago, and I really believe that I should have gone straight to Jack. I think it was more down to nervousness. I thought, knock on Jack's door and he's going to lose this fella, but I've since found out that Jack's not that type of bloke at all. He's a gentleman, and he certainly lives up to his nickname as of the Doyen of Australian boxing, and that's coming from a bloke who knows what the word Doyen means.
Well, they're trying to throw the Mad Dog tag off you. What's brought this about?
Well, I think basically what we're trying to get there, we're trying to give people the impression that Mad Dog, the image Mad Dog, is not the sort of person that I am as a person, really. It's an image, it's great for the ring career and everything. I let a bit go early on in my career, I let it go. I suppose I was a bit young and naive, and I was quite rapt. I was being acknowledged in some way, albeit the Mad Dog name. But now I think as a mature reflections. I can sort of look on it, and it's not really a good summing up. You go for a job interview, and they know you as Mad Dog. It's not really very good. All right. All the very best, Tony, in your career. Now we know you as Tony Miller. Good luck. Thank you. Listen. Well, Tony just mentioned before that he expected a pretty hard workout. Did you expect likewise?
Yeah, well, Tony's full of heart. He gives everybody a hard fight. But I'd like to say a few words on Tony's behalf when he fought Jeff Finnick. A lot of people don't realise this, but Tony at 9 stone 4 would give anybody in the world a hard fight. At 8 stone 10, he was like a kitten, no resistance, just had nothing. It would have gave Jeff a lot harder fight. As you can see, he was so weak, but he stood there for 12 rounds and slugged it out.
Well, Lester, your pattern, you're just back from a week in the Philippines, they tell me. You've performed pretty well if you've been lying on the beaches around there. But let's have a look at your situation now. What's Big Brother been doing with you, and where to go? Through the week, I noticed in the WBC, they've put you up to number one rating.
Yeah, well, on 28th of May, I'm fighting the lightweight champion from England in London, so that's a big fight for me. After that fight, I hope to fight on the Tyson bill in June. That's when Mike Tyson fights Spinks, so that'll be another good fight for me. I'm not getting too excited about world title fights, and I've been promised a couple of championship fights in the past, so that's just out of my mind now. I'll just take one fight at a time and just see what eventuates there.
Lester, thanks for having a chat with us here at Centre Ring. I notice also we've got another former world champion here tonight, and you looked down and gave him a smile. Barry Michaels here at Centre Ring. Lester, thanks for coming over and having a chat with us.
Barry Michael gave Lester Ellis one hell of a fight back in July of 1985.
Arthur Fennell and Russell Sanchez up in Newcastle. I'll be up there shortly to see the kids and my sponsors, John from Puma, and Arthur, thanks very much.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, our Australian champion, and hopefully our next world champion, Lester Ellis.